The president says women earn less than men, and he's going to make it a campaign issue for this year's elections again. Listen to this from Democrat Senator Barbara Mikulski of Maryland.
I am telling you, if we don't pass this bill, I'm so emotional, I'm going to press on. It brings tears to my eyes to know how women every single day are working so hard and are getting paid less. I get angry, I get outraged, I get volcanic.
Hold on a second. Turns out some Democrat senators should practice what they're preaching. This from the Washington Free Beacon. On average, Democrats in the Senate pay female staffers $5,500 less than men. I've got two specific examples for you. Senator Mary Landrieu, Democrat, Louisiana. The average male salary in her office, $13,000 higher than the average for females. Next one. Senator Kay Hagan, North Carolina, pays male workers $15,300 more than women. Monica, for a moment, let's move beyond whether or not men and women get equal pay for equal work. Forget about that just for one second. Seems to me that this gender pay issue doesn't have much traction for the president at the moment.
Not right now, but what you're seeing is phase two of the war on women. The original war on women a couple of years ago was based on free birth control, reproductive rights, all of the things that the Democrats pushed to really get women out and voting in 2012, and it worked. They had a lot of traction with women. They got them by huge margins last time around. They know they're in trouble going into 2014, maybe even 2016. So this is phase two of that. They're focusing on minimum wage. They're focusing on the alleged income gap. They're thinking that it's going to work. I think it might appeal to their base of women and get them riled up, but the broader population knows that the discrepancy does exist, but it exists because of choices that women have made.
Senator Mikulski says she's volcanic about this, but I don't think the country is reacting in quite the same way.
And the charge is bogus. That 77 cents to every man's dollar is completely bogus, and I think women in the workplace understand that they may be being paid less, but because of educational choices, risk choices, other choices that they have made in their career, time off for a husband and children, all of those things come into play, and women get that.
I see silence from the dynamic duo here.
Because the bigger picture, and as Charles eloquently pointed out yesterday when we discussed this topic, it's getting people back to work, period. I mean, why are we even talking about this when we still have 6.7% unemployment in this country?
That's why.
How about we just put more people back to work? Then we'll talk about the income gap.
I like that. Stay silent, Charles.
I will.